Hi there, how are you doing? It's just I made a previous video about Hillary crashing into the plane because I'm really fed up with the US. You know, it purports to be a democracy, but people at the top, the people in government, are clearly not a reflection or a representation of the people. You know, it's a, the whole political system is monetized. It's so obviously it's now a corporate state, and the fact that it constantly thinks that it should, you know, be ahead of everybody else. If you if you take a little bit of let's say this interest in obese people that are morbidly overweight, you know, why would you be a protector as a leader of a country full and be so proud of a country full with people that can't even run? You know. Or with a majority of them, full of people that are, let's say, 20% of which are living on food stamps. You know, how can you be proud of yourself? It's complete nonsense. How can you be proud of yourself of a country where people are lured into for-profit colleges and get an education and then be destitute and in debt and maybe prostituting themselves on the street for the rest of their lives? How can you be proud of that? I would be deeply ashamed of that. Simply dig a hole and try to bury myself. You know, if you're a politician of that country and as the people too, as a general public too, how can you accept that people pretend to do politics that clearly don't represent you? You know, it's a complete, you know, why would only the 2% of the population that happens to be, or the, it's not 2%, it's much less, of course, it's 2 promille. Of the population that happens to be a CEO of a big country, a company, suddenly be capable of managing you and other people not. That's complete bullshit and nonsense, and you shouldn't accept it. Why would you have to give financial donations to your politician? Where does that come from? Yeah, it's for his campaign. For what? For the marketing in his campaign. Against other politicians that try to do the same thing. So everybody gets fleeced. The only people that get rich are the marketers, or the people printing flags and renting these venues out for massive amounts. And then probably you find out that the venue is actually owned by one of the other politicians. You know, how can you accept that? It's just, it doesn't make any sense. You know, it seems to be in Holland that we are trending into the same direction, where politicians walk away because they realize that their job is a farce, it's a joke. And while they were passionate about something, they realize that they cannot be passionate and actually achieve something anymore. So they walk away. They say, okay, this is, I'm up against a criminal syndicate that's working together, is not telling the public what it's really want to do. And basically uses every means at its disposal to get its way. That has nothing to do with democracy. And you can immediately see by the state and the expectations of the population that it's not democracy. You know, education should be in high regard. Smart people should be regarded highly. But smart people aren't very, they're picky and choosy, and you have to deliver quality, which is expensive. So how can you mass produce? Well, you can mass produce for the plutonomy, for the rich, because then the costs can be recovered. But you cannot do that for the masses. You don't want to, so you make them stupid. You feed them crap. You know, macaroni and cheese. You know you love it. It's like, it's a double, it's the whole package. It's like a poor guy winning the lottery. You having to accept, or if you are poor, having to believe that you might be the one day that that will make these well, that suddenly makes it and be pulled into the spotlight and one of those millions of people, so that the rest of the time they can say, well, just wait for your chance, your chance will come. And then this guy is advertising macaroni and cheese, which is unhealthy, which you shouldn't eat. Well, you know, every now and then. But they don't eat it every day in Italy, because it's disgusting to do that. So crap fed to you by somebody that is used as an example. And of course, you know, that person, now I forgot his name, but he has real luck now. He has a job, which is not special, but he just got a job as an announcer because he has a good voice. Makes complete sense. Yeah, only he was completely homeless and lived in the bush for years. 2 years he lived in that place, he explained, together with another guy in a tent, just by the side of the road. And nobody provided him with somewhere to live, with a home. And and I have to watch, like, Huffington Post, it's completely taken over by Republicans. It's actually filtering out dissenting voices like that of Cenk Uygur, which I think is a complete disgusting thing for Arianna Huffington to have on her record. She should simply allow everybody to publish whatever they want to. This is a free speech country, they always say. Well, apparently not. But it now runs a piece about the new poor, the new homeless people. A mother with 3 children. Take her into your home, you know. Don't let her be homeless. What's the big crime there? What's the big difficulty? That you that you will lose status because you allow somebody to live in the back of your home or in one of the upstairs room or something like that. Temporarily, it's a mother of 3 children. She probably not behaves like a lion. I think lions are the most stinky animals in the world. It's kind of a random thing, but we call it jachtdierenverblijf, hunting animal area in the zoo. Is really if you would go to the zoo, you could smell that a mile away. For some reason, I'm not sure. Maybe that's because they're dangerous and they have all these pheromones that they do use to mark the territory. But a normal family that is on the street, you know, is completely capable. You can just rent your room to them, you know. Act like a human being. And I think that will be the breaking point when the majority of people realize that they might as well make life better for each other without thinking about money. And then they suddenly realize, hey, why do I have to pay for my politicians? And why do I then allow them to completely fuck up my country? Doesn't really make any sense. Well, who are these people? Who is Sarah Palin? Who the fuck is she? Can she go back to Alaska? Can we freeze her? You know? Can we put her in one of these oil pipes? You know, maybe that's a cheap way to transport her. Put her in a little pot with an oxygen bottle. You know? Can we tie her to the back of a moose and put a firecracker in the ass? Can it stop? Can it, you know, can it please end the whole nonsense? Because the 2% at the top are not the majority, and they don't have the power to subdue everybody that wants to have a change for a change. So you better learn, I think, you know, better try to find out whether you want to be inhabitant of asshole country number 1 or not. I am completely sick of it.